What's up, Taurus? All right, so look, as I was getting into you guys' energy, there was this sense of like pride. Like someone is looking at you with pride in their eyes. It's like you're their prize bull. Yeah, it's like you're their prize bull. You're the bullseye. Like you're exactly what they wanted. Okay, so this could be a past energy of maybe someone looking on like, man, that's what I wanted and I realize it now. Or there can be an energy of someone looking on who hasn't said anything yet and it's like bullseye, Taurus. I see. So we're gonna use this vintage oracle deck to get to one word to describe either. And remember, these energies work both ways. So you could be looking at them like this. They could be looking at you like this. I mean, it could be going both ways. Y'all could be looking at each other like that. But this is going to be a word to help us describe the energy that's happening now, okay? Playfulness. Bullseye. The target. Okay? Darts. Think about darts. Somebody's trying to, you know what I mean? So playfulness is the word to describe, you know, what's going on around you right now. You may have someone who has been flirty, or maybe you're feeling a little extra flirtatious, especially because I'm feeling this huge, heavy energy lift off of me of like heartbreak or resentment or anger or things that may have held you back in the past. It's like, I just want to smile. I just want to have fun. And if that's not the energy you're in now, that's what's coming up. Okay, stay busy. I don't know who that's for, but somebody, you need to go stay busy. Okay, go play, go to an arcade, you know, go do something childlike and innocent. Okay, let's see what we got for you guys at the center of the reading. Oh, Ten of Swords. So someone is done, stuck a fork in them. Okay, you may have decided, I'm done feeling down, tired, sad. I'm done crying. I told you this huge, heavy energy just totally lifted off. And it's just like, yes, I'm ready to have fun. I'm ready to smile. I'm ready to play. And that old mindset, that old self-destructive pattern of like negative thoughts, done. Stick a fork in them. Now, also, this is who you left behind. Come on, let's just be real. Okay, in order for you to have gotten to this playful energy, you had to drop somebody. Just like this person is dropped right there on their face, this is what you did. You dropped somebody on their face, and now you get to go have fun. The heavy energy is lifted, okay? Now, also, if you didn't drop somebody on their face, someone could be feeling like that, could be feeling like, they may have gotten dropped on their face. I'm just be real. The other way I'm seeing it, somebody wants to have fun, or somebody's out there having a great time because they recently broke up with somebody else. Okay, so it could be both of y'all going through the same thing, meeting in the middle. But whoever it was that you had to like leave behind to get yourself, to get your life, they're done. Ooh, Five of Pentacles. And now you ain't gonna talk to them, Taurus. Because this is your energy right here. So not only did you drop somebody and you're not talking to them, but you out having fun, living your best life without them? Ouch. Ouch. Okay, so whoever it was that you had to drop in order to go live your best life, that's what we're going to call this card. It's a playfulness, but let's just call it the living your best life card. Some of y'all decided, again, I'm feeling this heavy thing. It just keep coming off. And I feel like for some of y'all, it's coming off in layers. Like maybe it's this piece is a resentment. And then I was mad about that, but that came off. And then this part really, ooh, it made my blood boil. Now it's off. And this part, ooh, in the third party, in the karmic situation, pow, it's lifted off. It just keep coming off and coming off, and it's coming off as all these different layers. And that's how you got to this point. And that's for some of y'all, you see where you are now, and it's just like, pow, I'm just seeing a huge door slam, because it's like, I feel like if I get back around you, then I'm going to be the one in this energy again. Some of y'all didn't even have a shovel to dig yourself out of whatever ditch of hurt and pain you was in, but some way, somehow, you made it out. And that's why this playfulness card, for some of y'all who are still in this energy, you sad about somebody, you feel like somebody dropped you on your face, and now you calling them, you in the wrong vibe, okay? I'm gonna just tell you that. You gotta shift over to this because you the one supposed to be playing, okay? Don't tell the cross watcher. But you the one supposed to be playing, having a good time, fun in the sun. For some of y'all, I'm gonna just be real. Dang, look at all these little things I'm seeing today, okay? Some of y'all posting online, living your best life, okay? And somebody's watching and they feel like, how come I couldn't go? Or how come you didn't invite me? Or something. Wow. So I feel like whoever was the first present energy that I felt of someone looking at you, you know, they kind of, they feeling you, they adore you, all this kind of stuff, the flirty energy. It's like you have to leave one thing behind first. And that's what you're doing, or that's what you did. Okay. Let's see what we got. Ooh, the moon card. This is at the surface of it all. So you know what? I love this card because I've been studying it more and more. And it's like walking that unknown path. Okay, letting your subconscious be your guide. The things that you know, your forward mind may say, that's crazy. But somewhere in a dream, like you had a dream about it, or you had an epiphany, or it was just this download that came right through your crown chakra, and you like, that's something I should do. And you get led by like the moon, the subconscious, your supernatural, the spiritual world, all that kind of stuff. It exposes and it lights piece by piece as you're walking. But if you stand right here, I can't see what's down there. It's too dark. But each step that I take, the more illuminated it becomes by the moon, right? But I gotta walk in order to see it. And so y'all may be in a point or in a point where I'm gonna leave this relationship. I'm not gonna talk to this person for 3 days. Boom, boom, boom. 3 days later, the rest of the way is lit. If I can go 3 days, I can go a week. You know, that's how you walking out of a relationship, seeing that you're going to survive without that person, right? Or a job or whatever the case may be. But anyway, this moon card is your friend in this reading. It could have also exposed certain reasons why you had to leave certain things behind, certain behaviors, certain mindsets, energy patterns. You had to. It's new life. Okay. Let's see what's in the recent past. Ooh, Nine of Pentacles. Single. Okay. This is for those who are single, but this is also, if you're in a relationship, somebody who knows how to spread their own wings and fly. Okay. They don't have to be attached to somebody's hip. They don't have to be up under somebody all the time. They know how to do their own thing. They know how to make their own money. They are independent enough, but also they know how to coexist in a partnership. Okay. But some of y'all in the recent past could have recently became single. I'm feeling that with this because of this Ten of Swords and this Five of Pentacles. You had to leave one thing completely behind. And it's so amazing how we keep kind of going through this energy. And you want to know why I feel like we keep going through this energy throughout the year? Because sometimes these people come back, we give it a chance, we say this time is different, they changed, they're not the same person, and then boom, we see those little things, those little cracks happening again. We move through time, we say this person's changed, they're not the person they used to be, and then boom, those cracks start happening once again, and we start to see, all right, after the 15th time, maybe you just not who I need to be with, okay? But you just gotta know. Some of y'all just gotta know till you know till you know. When you know for sure, that's what makes it like you know, you can move on. Let's see what's in your headspace. Six of Pentacles. Look at all this money on the board. So this is generosity. Now that you've completely given this thing up, this Five of Pentacles now leads to the Six of Pentacles. Now you got that give and take, that reciprocity. Okay, now you've balanced the scales. All right. Now, for some of you all, if you want to see some results, now I just got a whole new vibe. Switch with me real quick over to money. Let's talk about the money. For those of y'all, if you got a dollar in your pocket right now, I dare you, whatever church is closest to you, I dare you to put a dollar in the offering basket. For those of you who have nothing, literally $3, like I don't have anything, I dare you to go give. Okay. Because some people, literally, you can read books of people who have sown their way out of poverty. You don't have a dime in your name, go down to your local soup kitchen, or go down to your local homeless shelter or women's shelter and donate your time, your energy, your effort, whatever you consider currency. Okay, you keep doing that scale. It's like, I give a little, I get a little, I give a little more, I get a little more. I give a little bit more. I get a little bit more. It keeps going. It's like the momentum, okay? First you giving a dollar. Then you giving $3. Then you giving $200. $2,000 coming back. You giving $5,000. $10,000 coming back. You see what I'm saying? So keep doing that. I don't know who that's for, but it's just something that's really pressing for me right now. Whatever area you want to see manifest, go give first. You want true love in your life? Go down to the little dog pound or the little animal shelter and go give all your love to them animals and them homeless, you know, sick animals, whatever, feed them, whatever. Let's see what we got up here in the what's coming up for you. The Judgment card. Okay, so there's going to be some, I forgot what sign I'm saying this to, but a reevaluation process, okay? Some of y'all are getting judged. You are, your seeds of harvest have been looked at, and now it's time to decide what you're going to get. It's like Christmas, man. It's like I'm feeling it like I'm Santa Claus or somebody, and I got a naughty and a nice list, and your name is on the nice list, and I get to give you what you've given all year. You've given a good attitude. You've given it your best. You try to make peace. Okay, cool. That's what's coming back. But for some of y'all, this is going to be that bringing you back up. Some of y'all have been down, have been sad, have been depressed. Okay? We rolling into the fall, which leads us into the winter, holiday season, all that kind of stuff where people may start getting depressed because they lost loved ones, things of that nature. But that's why this playfulness energy came up for you. Because it's trying to let you know that this season is going to be different. Okay, for those of you who starting to get, you know, maybe sad, S-A-A-D, that, you know, seasonal affective disorder, you guys, I feel like this year is going to be different. This year is going to be different. Who you attach your energy to in this fall season is going to be very important, because they're going to determine if your vibration raises or if it lowers. And you know what happens when that vibration lowers, okay? Open yourself up to all kind of stuff. But I feel like it's going to be a revival, regardless. We're coming up out of that. Let's see what you fear. The Queen of Cups could be a person. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy doesn't necessarily have to be that sign. It is just a person. Hold on. The first thing I just heard is this is somebody else's ex. For so those of you who have maybe recently met someone new, okay, you could be concerned about their ex or their baby mama or something like that, or them leaving you to go back with that person. Because I feel like there's something really fresh developing here with the playfulness. And you're concerned that this person may go back to their baby mama, or they're still dealing with their baby mama, something like that. Now, this could also represent like other people. Let's see. Queen of Cups. Ooh, two cards. Wow. Ay, yay, yay. The Queen of Wands and the Queen of Cups. Okay, so let me just put this into perspective here. Take whichever one of these energies you want. Okay, you can be the Queen of Cups or you can be the Queen of Wands. But again, I'm still feeling that dual energy where it's like you're concerned about the other person. Okay, someone's concerned about someone's ex, or someone's concerned about the baby mom or the baby daddy, whoever. Take it as it applies. Now look at here. We got the Hierophant in the middle. Let's talk about it. The Hierophant, contractual agreements, bonded, love, leases, all of that kind of stuff, right? So maybe somebody that person used to deal with. For some of you guys, you're dealing with someone who's living with an ex who they claim is a roommate friend. That's just my friend. Or they may be wanting to move in with you, or you feel some type of soul contract or spiritual connection with this person, but they're still dealing with another person. For some of y'all, this is your twin flame relationship where you're sitting or maybe wondering what's going on as it pertains to your person and the karmic. Yeah, I called that. Let's see what you look like, though. What you look like to other people right now. Ooh, the Emperor. The dominant one. The one who on top. Yeah. Whatever you're doing is working for you. Okay? Especially if you've... Like, I like the way he got his hand down like that on his goat thing. It's like he put his gavel down. He put his hand down. He put his foot down. His hoof down. Okay? And he not taking it no more. Male or female energy. Take it how it applies. But he put his gavel down. He slammed it down like he's in court. He's made a judgment call and he's not dealing with this no more. She is not dealing with it. Master of the game is how I'm hearing it. You are a master of your game, okay? And master of your craft, okay? A lot of people are looking at you in a form of self-mastery, like, you know what I just heard? Someone admires you and someone envies you. Whoa, two different energies there. Because of you being who you are. You just are who you are, okay? You don't have to compromise. If they tried to do some of the stuff that you do, they would get in trouble, but that's because they let other people be the authority. They would get laughed at, you know, but that's because they trying to imitate and be somebody else. You know what I mean? But because you do it authentically, it's not funny and it's not weird. It's just fit because it's just you. You see what I'm saying? And that's how people see you right now. So again, something's working. It might be this lighthearted nature. It might be the fact that some of y'all are lifting. Again, here go that lifting thing. It's, it keep coming off in layers. It's coming off again. Another layer coming off of some type of maybe depression or some type of anxiety or something. It just keeps coming off. And for some of y'all, that anxiety is only calling you to self-mastery. When you feel like, oh, something's wrong, I gotta do something. It's because your higher calling is calling and you probably, you know, need to go and do something pertaining to that. And I feel like that's where this judgment's coming from too. It's the spirit realm reawakening you and reminding you about your mission and what you're supposed to be doing. Let's see what you got in the hopes. The Two of Wands. So being able to make choices and decisions, and I feel like not being caught or bound, okay? Because even though sometimes we may choose something, it's like maybe when we choose it, just like with this moon card, and we walk three or four steps and it starts being illuminated, we may figure, oh, I don't like that pathway because I can see where that's headed and I don't like it, okay? So being able to be unbound from certain choices. Again, it's all going back to our word at the beginning, playfulness. If it's a playful energy, it's like, if it's here, it's here. If it's gone, it's gone, okay? Some of y'all are not looking to put your heart, mind, and soul into like a relationship or person because you're not looking to go through maybe what you've already come through, okay? You're just looking to live your best life, and that's okay. In this season, I feel like that's okay. For those who are not looking to be bound or be tied down to a relationship, you just want someone, a good friend, a good person, or whatever, I feel like that's all possible for you right now. But the only thing that's, to me, why we got to keep it playful right now is for those of you who are coming out of something, seems like the person, a new person that you may be interested in, may be doing the same thing, okay? And we got this other person there. Okay, so keep that in mind. Let's see what the outcome of all of this is. Ooh, justice. We balancing them scales. Again, I told you what I tell you about that demonstration. You give a little bit, you get a little bit more. You give a little bit, you get a little bit more. Boom, boom, boom. Two times with the scales, okay? So the justice card, karmic justice, raining down. This is for your past person. If anybody was dealing with anybody playing games between this year and next year, they gonna feel the pain. If they was playing games, they gonna feel the pain. You feel me? Between this year and next year, that karma is gone. Karma get the biting. You know what I mean? So don't be surprised people go running down the street. The little animals down there gonna be chasing, biting. Just make sure that you on the right scale when it comes to justice. Now, anybody dealing with any legal matters, major arcana, in the near future, you might be like reawakened or like if you were sad and down and out, you may have a new reason for hope or something like that, okay? You have a new reason to feel good. Some of y'all may have a family member in jail and it looks like they may be up for parole. Yeah. And some people may be coming out and being put on probation. I just heard a surprise get out. Like somebody getting out by surprise. For whatever reason, somebody getting out by surprise and they're going to be put on probation. Okay? And when I say probation, I don't mean like, oh, 3 weeks. I'm saying it might be like 2 years probation. Okay? So, is there anything else? I think that's it. Have fun, Taurus. That's the biggest advice. Keep it light. Have fun. I feel like I'm going to pull one more card for y'all. Keep it light. Have fun. And things will work themselves. I just heard, woo, you better sign, spirit. Things will work themselves out. Whoever needs to hear that, because somebody is struggling right now. Things will work themselves out. Will we get growth? Growth, 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 growth. Listen, it says, I want to expand my consciousness and my awareness. And that is where you're growing in your consciousness and your subconscious mind, taking the steps forward, being able to use your intuitive abilities to predict what's going to, you know, what pathway would happen, using your powers of discernment to decide before you make choices and decisions, okay? A lot of you guys will be using your powers of discernment when it comes to choosing people and how serious you should get or how much you should hold back. And then, for those of y'all that are so excited to go out there and stretch your stuff, you should be happy and excited too, because people are looking at you like you've done something amazing or you've gotten to a true point of authenticity that even if people don't like you, they still gotta admit, dang, at least you get to be you. You know what I mean? So that is what I get for you, Taurus. Thank you guys so much for all of your likes, your subscribes, your shares. I appreciate you guys so much. Make sure you guys keep the views going because you know the top five signs get those mind trips. So make sure you're telling your friends about Water Sign Vibes. You continue to comment, like, share, subscribe if you're not subscribed. All of that good stuff so you can get those mind trips, okay? Now, if you would like a personal reading, you can go ahead and look in the description box to see how you guys can list your questions and email them to me over at waterstarvibes@gmail.com, okay? You guys can also follow me on Instagram at waterstarvibes. Taurus, thank you guys so much once again, and I'll see you guys in your next video.